Before we close this topic of charge and Coulomb's law, there are certain important points about the charges. Like when we say the unit of charge is Coulomb, then it does not come to our mind that what is one Coulomb charge, how much is the one Coulomb charge. So we try to define it. We want to make a definition that how much is one Coulomb charge by giving you an example. And that example, we make it this way, that there are two particles. We keep them at a distance of 1 meter. And suppose we give them charge more and more, and we have given them a charge, let us say 1 coulomb and 1 coulomb, and we see the force between them. How to see the force between them? That's very easy. Let's put a force spring balance between them, and when they are repelling, they will pull apart the spring balance. We can see the force. We can always count the force by using any device. But this is just to understand that this 1 coulomb, 1 coulomb, 1 meter is the distance. Then according to our formula, force will be 9 into 10 to the power 9 into Q1, Q2, 1 into 1, square of the distance, 1 square. So this is 9 into 10 to the power 9. This is the force between the two charges placed at 1 meter if this is 1 coulomb. So this we will use as definition of 1 coulomb charge. Okay, listen it first. 1 coulomb charge is so much of charge that if it is given to two particles placed at 1 meter distance, then the force developed between the two particles should be 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton. That this quantity should be so large that force should increase up to this level, then we will say this quantity is 1 coulomb. That is 1 coulomb charge. Okay, so now I will write it in the words. Okay, 1 coulomb charge is that quantity of charge which, when given to two particles placed at 1 meter distance, exert a force of 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton on each other. So this gives us an idea what is 1 coulomb charge. Okay, now the next thing we study, what is the charge on one electron? Exact charge on one electron. Charge on one electron in terms of coulombs, it is 1.6019. Up to four digits you can remember it, 6019 into 10 to the power minus 19, but for all practical purposes you will use it 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, this is also known as fundamental charge. This we have studied, fundamental charge, because this is the basic charge on a particle which multiplies into different charges with the formula Q is equal to N. Then if we want to create 1 coulomb charge, how much electrons we have to give? The answer is we have to give 6.243 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. So many electrons make 1 coulomb charge. Coulomb is a very large quantity, so we use a smaller quantity, we call it microcoulomb. Microcoulomb. This is generally we use in our laboratory. Micro is 10 to the power minus 6. And notation for this is mu, microcoulomb. This we will be using. Now, we have studied that in physics measurements, we have 7 quantities which are taken as fundamental quantities. Is electric charge is a fundamental quantity? Answer, in that list, it does not figure. This is not a fundamental quantity. Then what is the fundamental quantity related to electricity? The answer is electric current is the fundamental quantity. And there is always a controversy between the scientists whether we should take electric charge as fundamental quantity and 1 coulomb as fundamental unit. But In SI system, we have agreed that we will take electric current of 1 ampere as fundamental quantity. How electric current of 1 ampere is related to Coulomb? So answer is, if this is a wire which is carrying 1 ampere and it keeps on carrying it for 1 second, then how much charge has crossed it? How much current is flowing? 1 ampere. The charges are flowing, and in 1 second, whatever quantity has flown through it, that quantity will be known as 1 coulomb. So this is the relation we have made, that 1 coulomb charge, 1C, 1 coulomb charge is equal to 1 ampere current flowing for 1 second. Okay, this is the relation between electric current and charge. And what is the fundamental quantity? Electric current in SI system. This is SI system. In CGS system, is there any electric charge quantity? The answer is yes, that is stat coulomb. In CGS system, earlier CGS system was prevalent, and in CGS system our formula was F is equal to Q1 Q2 upon R square, and this C was not there. Why? C was taken as 1. Only because we converted into SI system this thing appeared, because then we could not change the definitions. So in CGS system, how do we define in CGS system? This charge is known as electrostatic charge, or we call it stat coulomb. Electrostatics, stat coulomb. Stat coulomb is what? When a force, this force 1 dyne, this is 1 stat coulomb, 1 stat coulomb placed at a distance of 1 centimeter, the force is 1 dyne. So 1 stat coulomb is that charge which is placed at distance of 1 centimeter will exert force between the two, is equal to 1 dyne. Once again, if the two equal charges placed at a distance of 1 centimeter exert a force 1 dyne between them, then the charge will be said to be 1 stat coulomb. But in electrostatics, in CGS system, there were two units. One which was used in electrostatics, stat coulomb, and one which was used in electromagnetism, that was known as ab coulomb. So both are CGS, but this is for electrostatics and this is for electromagnetic effect. What is the relation between them? The relation between them is that 3 into 10 to the power 10 of ESU electrostatic unit is equal to 1 ab coulomb. This ab coulomb is electromagnetic unit. So 1 ab coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 10 ESU units, but all this is history. You study it, remember it only if it is in your syllabus. Otherwise, nowadays we are studying the same system, coulomb and its definition. Okay, so these were certain important points related to electric charge.